clothes.
Classwork, classwork.
He's still looking.
Give us the reference.
I already gave you, I'm looking for the hey.
No, you didn't give us.
You want to give him a ghost down.
You didn't give us the reference, sir. You didn't give us the reference.
Sir, first of all,
Zakir, that's your name, right?
Can you just confirm yourself? Can you confirm yourself? Because you are just, again, intentionally, it looks like you are lying. I ask you the reference. I ask you to reference.
Kabari,
give me the reference. Let me finish. I ask you to give me the reference. Where Gabriel identify himself or herself
as angel Gabriel,
who brings revelation to Muhammad.
Tabari and Buhari and the Quran.
You did not give me the reference. So
I told you Tabari and Buhari.
What was our question?
Okay, let's look at the and examine the verse again, and then you explain it to me how it works. I am okay. What Muhammad tells.
So he's the one who's going to tell you what the angel said, and the angel didn't send a voicemail to us, isn't it?
I don't know.
Voicemail?
Maybe
they didn't have phones back then.
Message. I don't know. It's the time of Muhammad. Yeah. You never know what Muhammad brings up.
That's what you asked about.
No. We asked you where Gabriel identifies himself.
We asked you Gabriel
identifying himself.
He did in a speech.
No.
I gave you a speech. I'll read it again if you want.
Okay, read it again.
Anyone can say it.
And explain that to us. Because that doesn't answer my question.
I don't think he understands the question.
And I want you to, if you cannot
prove... Oh, he understands and he's lying.
He understands what he's lying to.
Okay.
If he cannot prove...
Okay. Tabari and Ibn Ishaq write that Muhammad told Zubair... Alright. When I was midway on the mountain, I heard a voice from heaven saying, "Oh Muhammad, you are the apostle of Allah, and I am Jibreel."
Okay, let me respond.
There you go.
Okay. You still don't understand the question.
You don't understand the question.
Excuse me.
Let me respond. My question was, where did Gabriel identify herself or himself as a Gabriel I am bringing message? Gabriel is not talking. It is Muhammad.
The prophet,
can be lying.
Let's not cut each other.
How do you know he's not lying?
That's a different story, though. That's a different issue.
What do you mean it's a different issue?
No, don't cut him off. We'll let him finish.
Sorry,
let me explain what I mean.
No, let him say.
Zakir, you're trying to avoid it.
I'm not trying to avoid it.
I listen to you. Now you need to listen to me.
You ain't even let me speak.
One at a time.
You ain't even let me speak.
No, you read it. You read it, so you spoke.
Sir,
go on.
I asked. No, I'm responding to the statement you read it from the Tabari by reminding you what was my question. Sir, I haven't finished. Can you listen?
I know what you're saying.
Wait till she finishes.
You said, where did Jibreel say it?
Why are you trying to hijack the question? You're trying to hijack the conversation. Let her finish. Then you speak also.
Sir, wait. Let her talk.
Who was it then?
1% at a time. Let her respond.
It claimed to be Gabriel, which is what you asked.
Let her respond. Let her finish.
It was the quotation you gave it to me from Tabari. It was Muhammad. Muhammad is saying, I heard the voice. Let me hear. Let me give you an example. Do you hear the voice? Angel Gabriel is just telling me there is a
lamb. That's a different question.
Wait.
That's a different question.
Wait.
You know what?
I can tell you're nervous. When
since
you keep cutting
it,
I'm going to stay out of it.
Just wait.
You see what happened to you last time?
On YouTube.
Go watch it again. Go watch it again.
Okay. Okay.
Brother, have you noticed? Zakir, have you noticed that Zakir does not want to answer my question and he's attacking
you?
I apologize on behalf of him to you for his disrespectful attitude.
Since
you failed to give me the reference, Gabriel is speaking.
No, he didn't. You're lying.
You
didn't say Zakir behind the camera.
The story you read, it was Muhammad.
Quran.
If you don't have the reference, brother,
you guys just lying. Lying just flows from
your mouth. No, you can take it.
You're not even embarrassed about lying. You're not embarrassed about lying.
If you don't have the reference, where angel Gabriel is speaking.
Okay, I got it. Page 106. Okay? So I read it, I need to quote it from you. Alright, let me tell you now. And now it's quoting, I heard a voice from heaven saying, "Oh Muhammad, thou art the apostle of God, and I am Jibreel."
He's dead.
Read it!
Calm down.
Got it! Page 106.
Calm down.
Shut up, but I found it.
Wait, don't
Let me read it.
Okay.
Yeah, you got the proof now.
Let me read it.
Okay, read got it. The proof. I knew it was there.
So, yeah, just so. Let me read.
Page 106, reminder.
Guys, okay. Let me respond. Don't get that excited. This is Speaker's Corner.
Exactly.
So, we will see what happens to the Alhamdulillah now. Hear what happens. I asked the question, where does it Gabriel identify himself and brings revelation?
Page 106.
Sir, can you please follow up the rules and regulations on the... Sir, don't be child. How old are you? How old are you? How old are you?
Me.
What's his age got to do with this?
14.
How was it in camp?
40.
No, 1-4.
1-4. Yeah. So, Zakir is 14 years old, 1-4.
Hey, listen, I'm a heckler today.
1-4. Yet, I remember when you are 5 years old, you learn from your mom. When someone speaks, you listen.
So let me
Zakir failed to do that. So,
read it to everyone.
Let her respond.
I asked the question.
Oh, you ain't even let me speak for a
minute. I asked the question. My question was like this. You all listening to
the question, guys.
Where did Gabriel identify himself okay. as a messenger who is bringing revelation to Muhammad? That was my question. So, Tabari failed to show us that. Now let's see what the biography of Muhammad says. Please remember, it took over 25 minutes.
I still find it.
Can you please follow up the rules and regulations?
So now it's my turn to speak.
I haven't finished.
No, so she made a few claims, yeah?
Okay, number one. Zakir
speaking for half an hour.
I am going to respond.
If you want to talk to your camera,
my turn.
Let him talk to his camera.
Point number one. Point number one, the missionary says,
my name is Atul.
In the Quran, it says that the prophet spoke falsehood.
Okay.
The first point they made is, in the Quran, it says that if the prophet brought lies from God, his iota will be cut. The word in Arabic is watin. Now, in a hadith narration, before the prophet, peace be upon him, passed away, he said, I feel as if my iota is being cut. So they said, look, he failed the test of the Quran. In the hadith, the word in Arabic is abhar, and I read in the transliteration, and also in the narration, that's clearly an idiom. How do we know? At the prophet's funeral, a companion of the prophet, looking at the prophet's body and feeling sad, said, I feel as if my iota has been cut, meaning it was just an Arab figure of speech when you feel sad. So that doesn't work. Because they had a test that the Messiah cannot be crucified, yet Jesus failed the test.
According
to their own logic, Jesus is false.
Let me respond.
Who killed the prophet?
Okay.
It wasn't a poison. He lived years after that. Now, what's your other point? Number three. She said, where did Gabriel identify himself as Gabriel? I quoted Tabari, I mentioned Buhari, I quoted it to her. She said, show me in this book, page 106, read it to everybody.
Okay, let me. Okay. So it's my turn
now? Now your turn. How long?
Can we do two minutes?
Okay, go on.
Okay, so.
Who's training?
Okay.
I'm training, okay.
Brother, can you keep the time?
Okay, so I responded to everything. Sir, it's all a lot of nonsense.
Sir, yeah? Calm down. Calm down. So, can you start my time, please, brother?
Now I want someone else to take the time. Not
here. Minute.
Someone else, brother, take the time.
Let's see. Okay, my sister is gonna take the time.
Yeah. My brother's been taking the time.
Okay. Just a minute.
I want him to wait.
Sir,
I want him to. 2 minutes each.
Sorry, what was your name?
Are you ready?
Zakir. So, my name is Hatun. Okay, let me, if you are going to have the proper discussion, okay. I'll give rules are 2 minutes, okay? They respond to one another.
Start the timer.
And if I speak, don't speak over me. I won't speak over you, okay? So, my question was very simple. This gentleman came and then made a claim that Gabriel identified himself to Muhammad as a prophet. As an angel. I simply ask to back that up. You had over 25 minutes. You bring the references from the Sahih. You brought the reference from the Sahih Bukhari, Tabari. In the Tabari, when you read, it was Muhammad was speaking and saying, I heard that was the Gabriel. You did not provide any eyewitnesses from Tabari for me that they heard that voice. Not even one eyewitnesses. And then you made a claim, it is also the book I was holding in my hand. That time, it was the biography of Muhammad. And then after 25 minutes, here's the reference comes from page 106. Remember my question, where does Gabriel identify himself as an angel? Okay, here's the statement, page 106. I heard a voice from heaven saying, who is speaking? Muhammad, not the angel, not the angel. That's not why I am. Oh, Muhammad, thou art the apostle of Allah, God. I am Gabriel. That's not my question. I am asking the question, where did Gabriel identify himself to Muhammad? This is Muhammad speaking. I can simply say, oh, Lizzie, have you heard the voice? Gabriel just told us we are having lamb kebab tonight. Where is your witnesses, man? What happened to the witnesses? Where are the witnesses? If you cannot prove for me Gabriel identified himself, then give me your witnesses.
Okay.
My turn now?
No, he showed me the time has finished. Though.
Yeah. Okay, notice the change of goalposts. First, she said that I want to know where the angel Gabriel identified himself as Gabriel. I gave her the references, then I said, even a book in your hand says the same thing. She said, no, show me. Yeah, it took me time. I found it where the angel Gabriel said that I am Jibreel. Then she said, no, that's Muhammad's words. So Muhammad is narrating what the angel said, so the identification is there. But according to your logic, where is the witness? I want the words of the witness where Paul spoke to Jesus. Paul, everybody else heard no voice according to one of the accounts in Luke. So why is the proof that Paul really heard from Jesus? So her point is just changing the goalposts. Now, as far as the poisoning, the fool told the prophet is poisoned. The prophet did not die from the poisoning. He lived years after his companion died at the time. In fact, if the Jewish woman's criteria is true, even if the prophet died, the Jews had the criteria for the Messiah, that the Messiah cannot die, yet the Messiah died naked on the cross, according to the Christians. So by your logic, Jesus is also false and cursed.
What?
Then they said about the Quran, that in the Quran it says, if the prophet gave false revelations, we will cut his iota. The word in Arabic is watin, whereas in the Hadith, the word is abhad, and he was using an idiom, which is the same idiom a companion used when the prophet died. The companion said, I feel as if my iota has been cut. Same word in English, different words in Arabic. So her question doesn't make sense. She said, where did the angel identify himself? I'll give her it. Then she says, where are the witnesses? The next question should be, what is the proof that angel was really the angel? And that's the whole debate about the Quran or the Bible. Is Muhammad a true prophet? But the condition she gave that was met, as she's changing the goalposts. So we could use the same criteria back against Christianity. How much time is it?
10 seconds.
Okay, and as far as the last words of Muhammad, and may peace about the Jews and Christians, may they be cursed. That was so the Muslims don't make his grave a place of worship. And Jesus' last words was, my God, why did you forsake
me? Okay, your time is up. So, here's the issue. You all heard how Muslims are telling telling us, how Muslims are telling us, Muhammad is a false prophet. You all heard how Muslims are telling us Islam is a false religion. And you all heard how Muslims are telling us Quran is a false book. Reason for that is nowhere in Islam Jesus is identified as someone who has been cursed. A Muslim man just went against his Quran. Congratulations! Congratulations for proving us Muhammad is false, Islam is false, Quran is false. But I'm not gonna go with that sidetrack. Simple, I am asking simple statement. Where is Angel makes that statement? I'm not asking what Muhammad says. I don't care what Muhammad says. Tell me what Angel says, not Muhammad. So give me eyewitnesses who heard that. In the Bible, it is shame that you didn't even bring it up. Jesus get baptized. People hear the voice from heaven. People hear the voice from heaven. And then they tells us what the voice says. This is my son who I am now and well pleased with it. Give me your eyewitnesses who heard what angel said. How can I trust while you just confirm that Islam is false religion? How can I trust while you confirm that Muhammad is false prophet? How can I trust you while you confirm that Quran is false book? I will deal regarding the how did Muhammad died or killed when you answer my question. Where did Gabriel make the claim that he is the Gabriel?
Now notice something. She went on a tangent about how I said Jesus is cursed and Islam is false. We don't really believe he died on the cross. I think you need to update your research. According to your criteria, Jesus is cursed, because if the Jewish woman's test was true for Prophet Muhammad, her criteria, then the Jewish test for the Messiah is also true, which means Jesus is false.
I'll come
then
back.
She said,
just
oh,
answer
we
my
want
question.
The words of the angel, but the prophet is quoting the angel. Then she said, we have witnesses, eyewitnesses that heard the voice from heaven about Jesus' baptism, but this is going to cane her now. Shall I tell you why? According to Mark's gospel, and you can look at biblical scholars such as Raymond Brown, in Mark chapter 1, the voice says to Jesus, you are my son whom I love, with you I am well pleased. He only spoke to Jesus. How do we know the proof? Because Matthew's gospel changed it from you are my son to this is my son to make the crowds hear it. So that was a change in the story. The earliest gospel in Mark, only Jesus heard the voice, no ear witnesses. Matthew changed it to this is my son. And you can check out biblical scholars such as Raymond Brown. And she denies this. To tell her to explain why in Mark is you are my son. And in Matthew, the later gospel which copied Mark, is changed to this is my son, speaking to other people. So the Christians chain that story to make ear witnesses. Muslims don't need to do that to make our religion credible. You have to do that. How much time have I got? Okay, so according to her criteria, Jesus is a false prophet. His last words was, my God, why have you forsaken me? According to her criteria, Christianity is false. Islam is still true. She ain't given nothing against Islam. And I want you to read page 106, where Muhammad, on whom he peace, quotes the angel Gabriel saying, I am Jibreel. That's what you asked for. Don't change the goalposts. It's all being recorded. Carry on.
Have you finished?
Huh?
Okay. So, it's my turn now. Sorry.
She wants to say
sir,
said, I am
sir, just a moment. Okay, my turn now. We all noticed once again, how Islamic Dawatim, I come to the conclusion that you are part of Islamic Dawatim, how Islamic Dawatim comes to Speaker's Corner once again to discredit the Islam, to discredit Muhammad, and discredit the Quran. Sir, the moment you deny you are not Muslim anymore, I am happy to talk about the critics of the Bible, what they teach about the Bible. So far, you have to hang on the Quran, which tells, I came to confirm the previous revelation. Do not go with those people who do not even believe those things, okay? So, your Quran keeps you accountable, came to confirm the previous revelation. I will deal with the Gospels and their accounts when it comes to that. But until you prove for me, where does Gabriel says, I am Gabriel? You looked at the Tabari, no answer. You looked at the Ibn Ishaq, page 106, Muhammad is still speaking. I am asking, where is Gabriel speaking? That's different topic. So where is Gabriel stating that he is that angel? If Muhammad was very clear in that place that that was Gabriel, I wonder why he wanted to commit suicide when he first time met That's with right. the angel.
That's
right. Sir, I'm speaking. Can you listen to me? Can you pause my time, ma'am?
She wants when he says
sir, okay, I just stopped my time because you just decided to discredit me and then not listen to me. So, if that was so clearly angel Gabriel, I would love to know why Muhammad wanted to kill himself. But thanks to someone else, Jewish woman stepped in or wives of Muhammad stepped in. So, my question still stands in the round three. Gabriel states, I am Gabriel. Where is it?
Okay. To answer the question, it's in the very book she's got in her hands.
Show it.
The
Prophet read it for us.
Page 106.
Read it.
All right, can you go back to 106 so I can use my time? It was there and you changed the page. Page 106. Okay, see ya. Okay. Muhammad, thou art the apostle of God.
Who is speaking?
Jibreel.
Who is speaking?
The prophet's quoting the angel.
Muhammad is speaking.
Why are you interrupting me? Why are you interrupting me? Are you five?
I'm not five. I'm over
stop
five.
Interrupting me.
But stop interrupting me. You just misquoting. You just misquoted.
Wait, you just misquoted your scripture.
You just misquoted your scripture. I'm gonna give your time, but please do not destroy your scripture. Do not butcher your scripture. Please let him continue.
Okay, Ibn Ishaq is not my scripture, by the way. Get that fact straight. Okay, back to my time. Now notice she didn't touch on the Gospels. She said, we are witnesses that heard the voice from heaven. But that's Matthew chaining the story. Mark's Gospel, the earliest Gospel, only Jesus heard it, nobody else. Matthew chained the story, corrupted Mark to make eyewitnesses. Is that the basis for your religion? Then about the Prophet, peace be upon him, the suicide story is not authentic. There's hadith narrations that contradict that. But nevertheless, the Prophet, peace be upon him, when the angel first came to him and revealed himself, the Prophet taught us a lesson. Don't be gullible like these Christians. He went and investigated, pondered of it, and then came to the realization that it really is the angel. Unlike Paul, a voice comes, he doesn't verify it, and all of a sudden he's a prophet of God. We don't follow these type of religions. We follow evidence and verification. So the Prophet, anumi peace, taught us how to verify. So she hasn't responded to the poison. She hasn't responded to the iota. Sorry, the Prophet dying, she has to respond to why Matthew had to corrupt the claim that there were ear witnesses about the voice from heaven. Respond to that. Don't try to duck and dive. So the angel revealed itself as Angel Jibreel alayhi salam. She's been refuted. She's changing the goalposts. I haven't contradicted anything in Islam.
Time is up. Time is up.
No, I got 22 seconds. You interrupted me. So ask her, why is she ducking and diving? I want her to tell us, why did Matthew change Mark regarding the ear witnesses? In Mark, only Jesus heard the voice. Matthew changed it to the witnesses heard it. Explain that to us here, if your religion's so credible. Over to you.
Okay. It was, I think, over third time I asked the question. I asked it again and again. Where does Gabriel identify himself as an angel who is speaking to Muhammad? It is in, you told me, it's in the Ibn Ishaq. Not really, it is Muhammad speaking. It is Muhammad speaking. And we all know, Muhammad wasn't very good with his earrings. We know Muhammad's satanic verses. We know Muhammad tried to commit suicide because he didn't even know whose voice was there. So, simple question. Give me the name of the people who heard it was Gabriel identified himself. Since you failed to give me the verse, Gabriel identified himself. Suddenly, what happened? Well-detailed, well-explained Quran, 6,236 verses, yet not one of the testimony of Gabriel. Shame on Allah. Shame on Muhammad. Shame of the people who compiled the Quran. I already explained it to you why I'm not going to deal with your questions on the Gospels. Reason for that was Quran came to confirm the previous revelations. The moment you deny Muhammad, the moment you deny Quran, I am happy to sit down and and look at all those variations or the thing you think it's variations. But you know what? Yahweh is amazing. Ibn Ishaq, very book you just quoted, page 653, praises Matthew, praises disciples of Jesus, which goes against Islamic tradition. That means, again, Islamic Dawah Ahmed Speaker's Corner discredits Islam. Thank you. Where it says Gabriel is the angel.
Time's over. Now notice something. She said, "Oh, the prophet was going to commit suicide."
Sir, can you just not pull me around? Just like space.
The fact is, he never committed suicide. He went on to be a victorious prophet who brought monotheism to the world and died in the lap of his beloved wife. Whereas biblical Jesus did commit suicide.
Give me 1 second. Wait 1 second. If you want me to listen, wait 1 second.
You can listen with your ears while your body's there. Listen, also, the biblical Jesus did commit suicide.
Where is my iPad?
Yeah?
Where is my iPad? My iPad. Where is my iPad? Where is my iPad?
On top of that, notice she don't want to deal with the gospel. First she said, I want to know where there were ear witnesses to hear that Gabriel said, I'm Gabriel. And she tried to say that there were witnesses from the voice from heaven. But Mark chapter 1, the earliest gospel they got, refutes that, and she don't want to touch it. Matthew had to corrupt Mark to give ear witnesses. So that's the foundation of Christianity. As far as the satanic verses, that story is not authentic. The story doesn't make logical sense. You can laugh all you want, but the story is not authentic. It doesn't even make logical sense to preach monotheism all these years, all of a sudden preach polytheism, and not one companion bats an eyelid. You really want me to believe that makes sense? So Starry, deal with the point in Matthew and Mark about the ear witnesses. And as far as what she said, where did Gabriel identify himself? Page 106 in a book in her very hands. She's changing the goalposts. So my brothers and sisters, these missionaries have nothing. Poison story? Failed. Aorta being caught? Failed. And as far as the Quran confirming the Bible, the Quran makes it clear why it's confirming. Surah 7, 157, the prophecies they have with them. Not everything we have with them. And even if Ibn Ishaq, praise Matthew, Ibn Ishaq is not my God and he's not my prophet, so that doesn't mean nothing to me. Deal with Matthew. I want you to tell me why Matthew changed Mark to give you ear witnesses. The credibility of Christianity, according to your criteria, is finished. So tell us why Matthew changed Mark. Don't duck from it. I know your tactics. All right, Jay taught you well. All right, back to her.
No answer to my question. No answer to my question. Simple question. Where does Gabriel says, I am Gabriel bringing you revelation? It is the same question. No answer. This book, Muhammad is speaking, not the Gabriel. Muhammad is speaking, page 106, not the Gabriel. It's not the criteria I am looking for. You told me Gabriel identified himself to Muhammad. Now you can't even back it up. Shame on you, sir. You can't even back your claim up. So, simple question. Where did Muhammad, Gabriel, identify himself as angel? No. Nowhere in the Quran, nowhere in the biography of Muhammad, nowhere in the Hadith, nowhere in Tabari, just nowhere. That's my question. I am not going to answer your other questions until you answer my question. I am not satisfied the lies and the disturbed lies you are telling. And I already told you, do not butcher your scripture. You read the page 106. It was the Muhammad speaking. Muhammad was speaking. Regarding the Matthew, of course you will talk about it because you know, Quran has been changed and corrupted. You know, you look at the Bible and you see Muhammad is prophesied as the false prophet. And the Quran, Islam confirms, doesn't even know the voice of Allah. How can I trust someone who doesn't even know the voice of angel? How can I trust? So, simple question, answer the question. The moment you deny Quran and Islam, I am happy to look at the Matthew and Mark Gospel the way you are asking the question. But you must deny Islam first.
Back to me. Notice you make some silly points. The prophet on whom he preached lived in Arabia with no access to revelation. First time a spirit comes to him, what did he do?
something that makes me proud of Islam. He verified it. When he was satisfied, he believed. Not like Paul, who said that angels can be disguised as light. And the first time a voice comes from light, he believes it. I don't want to follow someone who doesn't verify. She says, why didn't the prophet recognize that it was an angel? Like Jacob, according to the book of Genesis, wrestled with God and he didn't realize it was God till later. So you tell us why Jacob didn't know he was in the presence of God. So Jacob can't recognize God according to your Bible, but the prophet should know the angel straight away. Okay. Notice something now. She never responded to why Matthew changed Mark. So they got no ear witnesses. She tried to say no companion of the prophet heard the angel Gabriel identify himself as Gabriel. And she tried to say, according to the Gospels, everyone heard the voice of God. But that's Matthew who changed Mark's wording, which made it clear only Jesus heard it. Respond to that, please. Then the point about the iota, she never responded to. As far as the prophet, peace be upon him, from the poison, according to the criteria of the Jews, the Messiah cannot be crucified. So if the Jewish woman was right, if the prophet alleged...
We all noticed once again Islamic Dawatim failed to answer the simple question. It was you who made the claim. I am asking the simple question. Where did Gabriel make that statement? Not answering the questions, not answering the questions and attacking the Bible is not an answer. That's not acceptable. You are over 5 years old. You should already know that. So, here's a couple of things, essential things. I think it's helpful for you to remember. I will look at the Matthew and Mark the moment you deny Islam. Because currently, Islam states, Quran came to confirm the Bible. Whatever Bible says, Quran came to confirm the Bible. The very book you try to find Muhammad, very book you try to find Muhammad and the angel, confirms and praises the authors of the Bible and the disciples, discredits the Islam. You told me, oh, if Muhammad recognized the voice of angel, it wasn't Muhammad. Muhammad went to commit suicide. It was another woman, wife of Muhammad, who helped him out. Who helped him out that actually, if Muhammad is a prophet or not, or who was that voice? Muhammad had hearing problems. He didn't know the voice of Allah. He didn't know the voice of Gabriel. He didn't understand anything. He needed to go to the woman. My question stands again. Please, please provide and back up your claims when you come to Speaker's Corner. Where is it Gabriel identify himself? I am Gabriel. I'm not asking what Muhammad says. The very book you shoved it to me, Muhammad speaks, not the Gabriel. Prove for me what Gabriel says.
Now I'm going to demolish Christianity in one go. What if I said according to the Gospels, the voice from heaven's a lie? Shall I tell you why? Because according to the baptism, John the Baptist was standing there. So would he have heard the voice from heaven if the crowd heard it? The answer is yes. But yet in prison, John the Baptist sent his messengers to ask Jesus who he is. Now can you imagine John the Baptist, who according to the Gospels is greater than Moses, according to Jesus. He's standing next to God in the flesh, doesn't recognize he's God in the flesh. Hears a voice from heaven, doesn't believe it, and sends these people afterwards to ask who Jesus is. Does that make any sense? So if the prophet on whom he peace is to be false because he didn't recognize the angel straight away, what about John the Baptist, who didn't recognize the voice of the Father from heaven and didn't recognize who Jesus was, which is why when he was in prison later, he sent people to ask Jesus, who are you? So does that mean John the Baptist is a false prophet? Answer that, please. As far as the Quran confirming the Bible, I responded to that. The Quran does not confirm all the Bible. The Bible teaches the crucifixion. The Quran denies the crucifixion. The Bible teaches Jesus is the Son of God. The Quran denies Jesus is the Son of God. So what are you talking about? These polemics ain't going to work on me. I'm sorry. Notice she's learning from Jay. What Jay told her is when a Muslim raises an issue against the Bible, don't respond to it. Just bring it back to Islam. She won't tell us why Matthew changed the words of Mark to not you are my son, but this is my son, to make it sound like the crowd heard it. In fact, the proof the crowd never heard it is that later John the Baptist sent these messengers to Jesus to ask, who are you? Are you the one, or should we wait for another? So if John the Baptist, according to them, couldn't recognize
God in the flesh standing next to him, why do you have an issue with a prophet not believing the angel straight away but taking time? And even if the prophet's wife helped him come to an understanding, you got an issue with a wife confronting her husband? You got an issue with that? Something wrong with that? Yeah? So John the Baptist couldn't recognize God in the flesh standing next to him, but the prophet Muhammad and whom he peace is false because he didn't recognize the angel straight away. Does that make sense?
Time is up.
Tell it to respond. And this is the last 2 minutes away.
Is this the last?
And you have it and I'll have it.
No, you started, so I have to finish then. So I'll have
you
it.
You started.
No, you started.
You started.
Who started? Yeah, you started. No, you started. You started.
Remember when I kept saying you're not giving me time to talk? Look, I'm a guest from another city. Just let me be the last one, please.
No, why? I don't think you deserve that.
And guests, don't they?
Okay.
Show your love to me. Show your Christian love to me.
Not even one question of it. Not even one.
Sir, you are already recording. You should not. No, sir. I think you started. We will check.
Okay, just have your way.
No, it's not my way. It goes with the principles. So we will check it out. Who started first, and then we follow from that.
We're not going to rewind the camera now.
So, what is it? Can I have a little bit space? It's a big issue. So, as I stated, since the Quran states that it came to confirm the previous revelations, couple of times, again, and again, the moment when you challenge my scripture, you must deny Islam, you must put or poison Muhammad once again, you must put your Quran under the bus. That's the way I can respond to you. The moment you poison Muhammad again and deny him, I am quite happy to look at the Bible. But the moment you still stand here and then say, I am a Muslim, the moment you stand here and then say, you are a Muslim, you have to take this as your authority. It came to confirm. I asked the simple question. Where is it Gabriel states, I am Gabriel? You spent 25 minutes while I was on the ladder. You brought page 106 of Ibn Ishaq. It's Muhammad speaking. That's not what I am looking for. You looked at the Tabari. Tabari is not saying that either. It is Muhammad speaking. I am asking, where is Gabriel says? Who are the people who hears that? Regarding, we all know Muhammad had bad earrings. Muhammad had bad issues. One of the issues Muhammad had was he didn't know, he didn't recognize the voice of God.
Isn't it too
much? Therefore, you need to provide for me. Gabriel make the statement that he is Gabriel himself. The moment, this is your last 2 minutes, deny Islam, and then I will respond to Bible questions.
Okay, now, in conclusion, notice she did the J. Smith tactic. She didn't respond to why Mark was chained by Matthew. She didn't respond to, if Muhammad and Umi peace is a false prophet, why is the allegedly greater prophet than Moses, John the Baptist, didn't recognize God in the flesh and didn't recognize the voice? Because if God the Father really told him that this is my beloved son, meaning Jesus, would he have to go to prison and send people to ask Jesus who he is? So John the Baptist is false according to her narrative. No ear witnesses. That's why Matthew changed Mark. She didn't respond to that. She didn't respond to the poison. She didn't respond to Jesus being false according to her own criteria. She didn't respond to the prophet peace be upon him allegedly not committing suicide. But Jesus did commit suicide. So every point she brought up, she was refuted on. She asked, where did the angel Gabriel say that I am Jibreel? I gave her, I've given her already, page 106. I gave her where the prophet peace be upon him revealed that the angel said that I am Jibreel. She said, no, that's the words of Muhammad. But that's like me asking her, where did Jesus say before Abraham was I am? And then she quotes John and I say, no, that's John quoting Jesus. I want Jesus' words. So if the Muhammad and Umi peace can quote the angel Gabriel, John can quote Jesus, what's your issue? So she's going around in circles. She ain't responded to nothing. Remember, she tactfully avoided Mark being corrupted by Matthew. Remember that, because this is the tactic. Mention Islam when Christianity is on the hotline. I don't fall for this nonsense. You ain't going to beat me on that. And in fact, get any of your representatives to debate me on stage on is Muhammad and Umi peace a true prophet. Bring them to the UK. I'll debate them on stage.
So look at the issues. The Prophet, peace be upon him, verified about the angel, whereas Jacob didn't know he was resting with God. John the Baptist didn't know he's baptizing God in the flesh. Paul didn't even verify in the belief. Paul, the Prophet Muhammad and whom he peace, verified. And that's an example for us Muslims, not to believe when Holy Spirit speak to us, but verify it. Unlike, that's why we don't fall into Christian traps. That so, the Holy Spirit
sorry,
told me last night.
Sorry, your
term
is up.
Your term is up.
Oh, I haven't finished, sir. Why are you going?
What? Conclusions?
Yeah, I'm making my conclusion. Why are you walking away? That was one of the awesome Islamic Dawat in came to Speaker's Corner. He made his conclusion and ran away. That is just disgraceful. That is disgraceful. So let me just sum up what happened. Islamic Dawatim made a claim. Gabriel identified himself as the Gabriel to Muhammad. No proof from any of the Islamic sources. Not even one proof. We know from the Quran, Muhammad failed to identify the voice of Allah. Muhammad failed to identify the voice of Gabriel, all those satanic verses. And Muhammad needed to get a confirmation for his revelation by going to his wife. Of course, I'm not going to respond to questions on the Gospels. First of all, because Islam confirms the Gospels. Islam confirms the Gospel. While Muslims are challenging the Gospels, they go against Islam. I don't want my Muslims to commit sin. I don't want them to end up in hell. I'm just helping them out to obey their teachings of their scripture. The moment that gentleman who just ran away, the moment he denies Islam, I am quite happy to go through the Bible and talk about it. Until he doesn't deny Islam, then he has to stick. Bible is the reliable word of God. Here's the issue, other issue. When Muslims tell us John the Baptist cannot be the prophet, Jesus cannot be the prophet, they again go against their teachings. Quran confirms John the Baptist as prophet, but Muslims deny that. That's a big, big, terrible place for them to be in front of God on the Day of Judgment as they deny the word of God. But bottom line is this. Muslims put their faith in a book. They cannot even back it up. They put their faith in arguments. They cannot even back it up. He's still hanging around and he doesn't even want to listen to my conclusion. That is just disgraceful. But Muslims would know. Islam is a dangerous and false ideology. Reason for that is Islam comes and preaches another gospel and another God, which goes against the teachings of the Bible. Bottom line is this. Muhammad, who got poisoned by a woman, thanks to Allah, he was stopping Muhammad to preach the false things. Allah used the woman to kill Muhammad by food poisoning. Jesus is the one who offers everyone to eternal life by dying on the cross for the sin of man. Muslims can ignore that because Muhammad ignored that, because Quran ignored that. But my question has not been answered again.